There's a lot of footage captured on board space station, both internally and externally. But NASA has two specific HD external video camera systems that serve a lot of scientific purposes, but also just public affairs and public interest purposes. Now, the space station has had external cameras on board since they put the station up in the early 2000s, but they were standard definition 4x3 cameras specifically designed for the station. But in 2014, all of that changed. A Dragon spacecraft was launched from Cape Canaveral containing several experiments, one of them being the high-definition Earth viewing camera, also known as HDEV. The camera system was mounted on the outside of the Dragon spacecraft, and it was retrieved by one of the external arms on the space station and attached to a platform on the exterior of the European Space Agency's Columbus lab. It's the first large unpressurized NASA experiment sent up by SpaceX to the space station. Now, the HDEV contains four different cameras from four different brands, and this is very important. NASA wanted to be able to acquire commercially manufactured cameras so that they could figure out an enclosure system to put these cameras in. That way, they don't have to constantly keep creating custom cameras that can withstand the elements of outer space. If they can just create an external enclosure and those cameras survive, that's just a much more cost-efficient way so they can buy cameras off the shelf and put them inside an enclosure so they can survive. The HDEV is mostly famous because it is the camera system that is live streaming via Ustream to all of us here on Earth. I had the pleasure today to talk to Paul Muri, who is a NASA engineer that currently is maintaining that live stream down to Earth. He explained to me how the different camera angles and systems work. The Hitachi camera is pointing in the direction of the space station's orbit. The Toshiba camera is pointing towards Earth. The Panasonic and Sony cameras are both pointing away from the station's orbit. They have these different angles so that as the station orbits around the Earth, the cameras could always be pointing towards a particular location on the Earth's surface. And the main experiment for this module is just to see how these cameras survive when they're exposed to space. And so far, it's going pretty damn good. According to Paul's analysis, and including all four cameras, there's only 30 dead pixels on those cameras. I would say that is very good. I mean, losing a couple pixels on a camera that doesn't go to space is honestly not really that surprising. And when you have 30 pixels across four different cameras while they've been in space for 2 years and constantly in use, that's excellent. Scientists have also been able to use the footage from these cameras over the last 2 years to analyze how the geography of the planet is changing. The HDEV is supposed to be retired by the end of this year, which means the live stream on Ustream should be coming to an end. But NASA may have a backup plan for that, but that is still to be determined. The second HD external camera system is called the External High Definition Camera Assembly, also known as the HDC. So many acronyms, oh my god. This camera system is unique because it's mounted to an already existing standard definition camera system on the outside of station. This system is designed to pan, tilt, zoom, all kinds of stuff, but mostly analyze the station and seeing how it's dealing with the weathering of space. But it also points towards Earth and captures some really great HD footage of the planet. So when this camera system came on board station, it actually had to be installed via spacewalk. It's a job that just requires a lot more finesse than a robot that can only do so many things with its, arm. The advantage of using a Nikon D4 over the older HD cameras that are on board the HDEV is that it can also take raw, high-resolution stills that can be set down to Earth to be analyzed and just kept on file for historical purposes. These cameras are just a constant reminder that there are people in space working for humanity and just doing research and science that is only going to benefit us all. So I hope this video answered some questions for you. Now that when you see hurricanes or other natural phenomena happening on Earth from space, you know what camera shot them. Again, thanks a lot for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. We're growing at a steady rate. Can't wait to keep making videos for you. Thanks.